Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor is the U.S. military's crown jewel when it comes to air superiority. So are there any other aircraft that could give it a run for its money? What about the Eurofighter Typhoon? Glad you mentioned that. Maybe that seems like a silly comparison, given the Raptor is a 5th-generation fighter and the Typhoon is only a 4.5-gen aircraft. Surely with stealth, the US-built F-22 should best anything in the sky, right? But generation designation isn't everything, and comparing these two planes is not all that crazy. And our conclusion on which is the winning aircraft may surprise you. But before we talk about combat scenarios between these two birds and declare a winner, let's take a look at some of their impressive features and tech specs. The Typhoon has a wingspan of 36 feet and is 52 feet long. The Raptor's wingspan is 44 feet and is 62 feet long. The Eurofighter sports two Eurojet EJ200 engines capable of 60 kilonewtons each and 90 kilonewtons in afterburner mode. The F-22 is powered by two Pratt & Whitney F-119 engines that provide 116 kilonewtons each and 156 kilonewtons in afterburner mode. At altitude, the Typhoon is able to reach speeds of up to 1,550 miles per hour and supercruise at speeds of up to Mach 1.5. The Raptor comes in at 1,500 miles per hour and a supercruise of Mach 1.8. The Eurofighter can climb 62,000 feet per minute with a service ceiling of 65,000 feet and a combat radius of about 850 miles. The F-22 can climb 69,000 feet per minute, also with a service ceiling of 65,000 feet and a combat radius of around 500 miles. The Typhoon has a 27mm Mauser cannon that can fire up to 1,700 rounds per minute and carries 150 rounds, where the Raptor has a 20mm Vulcan cannon that can fire at up to 6,000 rounds per minute and carries 480 rounds. The Eurofighter can carry several air-to-air and air-to-surface missiles which are externally mounted, such as the Iris-T and the Brimstone. Since the F-22 does not mount its weapons externally, it would typically carry 6 AMRAAMs and 2 Sidewinders for an air mission, and in a ground attack scenario, just 2 of each along with 2 precision-guided bombs. The Typhoon's most notable avionics feature is called Pirate, or infrared search and track technology that can detect low observable aircraft up to 50 kilometers away and carries chaff to thwart radar-guided missiles. The Raptor's radar system can detect aircraft nearly 200 kilometers away and uses flares to defend against heat-seeking missiles. Alright, so down to brass tacks. Who would win? The Raptor or the Typhoon? Well, the answer depends on whether we are talking about a combat that is within visual range or beyond visual range. In the case of a dogfight scenario, the Eurofighter is impressive once in the merge. Although the F-22 has thrust vectoring and a higher angle of attack tolerance, the Typhoon is able to conserve its energy better, a significant dogfighting advantage when climbing, turning, and diving are crucial to attaining a kill position. So for the WVR scenario, we would give our nod to the Typhoon. So now let's talk stealthy attack. This is where the Raptor brings its A-game. Take its stealthy design, combined with AMRAAM missiles that have a 100 kilometer range and a radar that can detect enemy aircraft nearly 200 kilometers away, and its deadly advantages are clear. Even with the Typhoon's Pirate, we think most days the Raptor would take out a Typhoon before it even knew the Raptor was there. However, soon the impressive Meteor air-to-air missiles may be carried by the Typhoon, and with its 300 kilometer range, we will be watching to see how that plays out. But what are the chances these two aircraft would actually meet one another in the skies? Well, only the US military has F-22 Raptors in service and is not sold to other countries or militaries. The Eurofighter Typhoon, on the other hand, has more than 500 planes currently in use by Austria, Germany, Italy, Oman, Saudi Arabia, Spain, and the UK. Kuwait and Qatar have more than 50 on order. And while it's unlikely that the F-22 would encounter a Typhoon in actual combat, it is possible in the future, particularly if one of the countries with Typhoons no longer has a good relationship with the US. We saw it when the US sold F-14 Tomcats to Iran, and it could happen again with the Eurofighter. Ultimately, the success of combat between these two powerhouses comes down to a combination of the plane's capabilities and the skill of the pilot. Whether we are talking about a good old-fashioned dogfight or a stealthy attack, it would be a close fight if these two were ever to meet for real. So who do you think would win? And what would you like to see from us in future aviation videos? let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, we would be honored to have your subscription. We're 2-Bit Aviation. Thank you for watching.